Okay, Xander Totorok, I'm with Mike from The Raven Age.
Yes, hello. Amazing.
Cool, you look different to last time I seen you.
Last festival I was at, had a bit of a haircut, and for a while I've been doing this, you know, short sides kind of thing. But this French lady just decided that she was going to take a cutthroat out, and she put it a bit closer to my head than I would have liked. But I've also been around the world for a little while now, so I feel different.
Yeah, you've been on the world tour?
Yeah.
Wow, how long?
We've been out since, well, we left on the 19th of February to go to Florida, and we played our first show on the 24th. It's been pretty much a show, day off, couple of repeat shows since then.
Well, it's nice to have the days off, though.
It is nice to have the days off.
Yeah, there's a lot of air travel as well.
A hell of a lot of air travel.
Yeah. How many countries?
I think it was something like 36 or 37 by the time the tour's over. It was 55,000 miles or something. I don't know the exact figures because we added dates and we changed some stuff around on the way, so...
Yeah.
But absolutely ridiculous.
Wow.
Crazy.
Every continent as well.
Yeah.
Wow. How old are you?
29.
Oh, okay.
I turned 30 just after we finish.
Okay.
Which is just going to be amazing. Oh, I've done that before I was 30.
Yeah,
wow.
There you go. Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
Wow. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. What's been the highlight?
I couldn't even tell you because it's just literally so many. Every day or every other day, getting on Ed Force One is kind of a highlight. It doesn't matter who you are. No, it's. I'm not sure what I'm allowed to say about it and what I'm not, but I have never been upstairs, so I don't know where the band are, and I don't know what goes on up there. If they've got beds and things like that, I'm assuming they have. Well, I wouldn't say that because obviously, you know, George is my mate, and he knows Steve very well. So I could probably get up there if I needed to, but you know, you give them the time and space, just be sensible. I've got three seats to myself, and every so often they push me up to first class and let me travel in the electric seats that lay right down and stuff. So it's good.
Is it just like a normal 747 inside then?
Yes and no, it is, but there's a lot of the seats that have been taken out and things like that, so there's like a standing area, a lot of people stand around and have drinks. I know I'm allowed to say that because there are photos of that online, and obviously Bruce invited some people on to actually check the plane out and have a look around, so I'm assuming that it should be public knowledge. I hope so, or I'm in trouble.
Yeah, this sounds more secure than Air Force One.
I saw a great picture of, I can't remember where we were, might have been Chicago, but we were actually landed... And they had a picture of Air Force One on the ground, and Air Force One was taken off behind, or something like that. But it was it's pretty impressive, yeah.
Okay, so there's a bar. Well, I guess you can have there's a technically bar in place anyway. Is there an actual surface bar there?
No, but any surface is up for grabs. You can use your tray, you can sit on the floor, you can kind of do whatever, as long as the seatbelt signs are off. And to be honest, they're not exactly tight on those regs either. I mean, an amazing experience was a couple of the 11.5 hour flights, so the longer ones. We actually we got some of our EP boxes, stacked them out, and then we got a tablecloth, and we played poker whilst we were on a plane. It was incredible.
And the good thing is, you don't have to worry about your stuff getting damaged because you haven't got the airport handlers doing it, have you?
Yeah, well, it's been very hit and miss on that front. Sometimes we've literally carried our stuff to the plane ourselves, and other times it's been. It has occasionally been with the airport handlers, but anything that's real serious that you know you don't want to take with you, you can just leave on the plane most of the time.
Yeah, and that as well. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Nice. And then you got the damage as well on the plane.
Change yes. It did kind of suck because we've obviously made friends with some of the flight crew, so we were enjoying like spending nights out with those guys, and they got stuck in Chile for 10 days I think it was, which is still an incredible amount of time to repair two engines on a giant plane. I think they were like $4 million each or something ridiculous. So yeah, the pin popped out, to my knowledge, of the little I don't even know what they're called, but the vehicle that taxi the planes out, one of the pins popped out, and so the plane kind of went into that. And funnily enough, I actually sit above the right wing, if you're looking at the plane front on, the one that was damaged. So it's like, I'm looking there on the first flight, two new engines underneath me. I hope they're okay.
Yeah.
But I'm still here, so obviously they are.
So where's next to go?
I believe we're going to Oslo in a couple of days, and then we've got Grass Pop Festival after that, which I'm really looking forward to because I heard that's pretty cool. One of the other places I can't wait to hit is Sweden, because where we're playing is a 75,000 cap venue, and Chile was 60,000, but it was sort of in the daytime, and I think this one will be a bit different. It's going to be really interesting.
Are they the two largest venues?
Other than festivals, as far as I know, and it's very difficult to tell how many people are at a festival. I mean, for our second experience at UK Download, I can tell you that last time we played on Jake's stage, which was obviously like stage four, and we bumped up this, which was just amazing because we were probably playing to 500 people last time, and this time, I don't know, if I hazard a guess, it was probably 10 times that. It was more like 5,000 by the time the rain had kicked everyone into the tent.
Which is always good.
it's horrible, and you hate walking around in it, and if you're at the festival, you can't stand it, especially if you're in a tent.
The rain, yeah. Yes, but it's good to have the tents also because you've got somewhere to retreat to.
Exactly, so when you're playing in the band, the rain isn't quite that bad. Unless you're on main stage and, you know, there's no tent.
Yeah, you've got to try and warm the crowd up properly.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so on the tour, have you been first on?
Yes, we were first on a few times, obviously when it's just been us and Maiden, because we wouldn't go on after them. But we had Anthrax with us, amazing guys, love those guys. They were with us for most of South America, and more recently we've had Ghost on some of them.
Amazing. They just pulled out today.
You know what? I really hadn't heard much of Ghost, and I saw Cerise being played live, and I just went, that's really cool, because it's different, it's interesting, you know. So I've had a chat with a few of the guys. Obviously it's really nice to be bumping toes with that sort of crowd, and I've had a good time. I managed to get a couple of photos with Papa Emeritus the Third and a couple of Faceless Ghouls, so that was wicked. It's a real shame. Yeah,
I've
yeah.
I've seen them recently on tour. I love how the guitarists all play together. They stand in a little group. Did you notice
it's
that?
It's very clever, and obviously all the face masks are designed to look exactly the same. Yeah. And it's eerie. The first time we saw them, it was at a festival, and as a Ghost t-shirt. And it was very bizarre because they were getting changed in the room opposite, and they all walked out all fully masked up, and it was like, wow, it was pretty freaky.
Intimidating.
Yeah. Yeah, but they're great guys, so.
Yeah, nice. Right, well, I've got to let you get on.
Okay.
Tell us about your latest release quickly.
Latest release?
Yep.
Well, that'll be the album that's coming definitely by the end of this year.
This year.
We recorded it. It was finished by pretty much the end of May, so that's what we're going for.
Good
it'll be
go.
A release before the end of the year, after the tour's done, when people know who we are.
Yeah.
So, yeah, check it out.
See you later.
Yeah. Excellent. Of course. No problem.
Great to catch up.
Perfect. Soon. Thanks, man.
Cheers.